game is love. Yeah, I gotta keep it trilly on my soul. I'm the most selfish person that I know. Here we go, down the rabbit hole. Got a couple carrots around my neck. Self-respect, when you out of line, you put yourself in check.
Hello, this is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. Today we're looking at the new effect, mReveal, for MotionVFX. mReveal, once downloaded via mInstaller, can be located in your effects. As you can see, we have 101 reveal items in our effects, which is pretty awesome. And we're just going to go over a few of these today and show you how to apply those and why they are useful. Now, you'll notice that these are primarily used as transitions. However, they're not located in our transitions. They are indeed located in our effects. And I'm going to show you why that's important in the way that these were built. So as you can see in our intro, we have several clips that were stacked on top of each other. Something else to note, you can use these on title layers as well. You can see that there obviously are no transition layers going on, but when we go into our clip and we look over in our inspector, we can see that we have an animation in and animation out for these clips, and these are essentially the transition toggles. However, if you look down, you can see we have multiple mReveal inside of our clip, and that's where this really shines, is that you are able to quickly and effectively mix these, match these, and create your own unique effects for in and out animations that are really, really cool, as well as you're not affecting the layer beneath. So let me explain to you and show you what that means. So here you can see we have a clip of our guy just kind of riding his BMX bike through the street. So to get a real-time preview of what this may look like, you can have your clip highlighted and then just scroll over your mReveal, and you can see how that's going to look in and out so that you can get a real-time preview of what those are going to look like. So why don't we just click, pick that up, and drag it in. And you can see over in our inspector that we now have animation in and out. We have a mode in this particular mReveal 2, adjustment scale, graphic, element bulge, etc. So let me show you what that means really quickly. So here, this is where we are starting within our clip. We can toggle animation in and out off if we want. We have a mode for full screen or graphic element, which essentially all that means is if we wanted to turn this into some sort of a frame or something that's happening on top of another clip, we do that with our adjustment scale. So when we are in graphic element, the graphic element bulge is here, and that is going to only be affected when we're in that mode. So just keep that in mind for this one in particular. You can see it does nothing here. And then we have desaturation, edge blur, and desaturation mix. So really pretty simple, but that's happening in and that's happening out, as you can see. Now what's really cool is if we drag this down, we can see that now the out is just automatically there. It's going to happen in those last couple of seconds out, so you don't have to worry about, oh, do I have enough media for this, the way you would with a transition. It's just always going to be wherever that is positioned in the in and out space. Okay, so this is where it gets fun. I'm going to drag this clip above my next clip, and as you can see, this is only affecting the top clip. Now, with most transitions, this would also be affecting our clip beneath, but that is not the case. It is only going to affect the clip that you have the effect on. So that means you don't have to add a transition and then make a compound clip. No, no, you're good to go here. And the other fun thing about this, again, is that you can stack these on top of each other. So now you can see that both effects are happening. We've got the bulge, but then as I scroll over mReveal 11, we're getting both the bulge and that sort of glitchiness that's happening. Or let's say we wanted mReveal 16. We have this kind of crazy prism thing going on. or mReveal 17, which is kind of a glow. So you really get 101 items to create your own unique in and out animations that can be used as transitions, and you can create some really unique looks really quickly by simply clicking, dragging in, and now you can see how that has affected that on the in and the out. Really cool. So mReveal 34, you've got our mode, then, you know, obviously if you want to do graphic element, you do that as well here. Then we have our threshold, our threshold smoothness, and then a lot of goodies down here with dust and dust direction and all kinds of stuff. So really cool. I don't have obviously enough time to show you all 101 items. We did want to do this quick tutorial to show you how these are useful and why they are built in the way that they are built, so that you're not affecting clips beneath, you're only affecting the clip, and you're able to stack these within the same elements. And of course, the way that the layers are, if I were to drag this above, it's going to affect it differently, right? So now we can see that our mReveal 34 is affecting the inside of that clip, and then our bulge is happening. So the hierarchy of the layers within the effect, within the clip, matter as well. All right, once again, this is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. mReveal is now available on MotionVFX. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.